Hey, what's up guys? Here's another video. It's been a while since the Krabby. I just didn't have the time to come up with and create some fun stuff to do with Gearheart and Imitation Game, that kind of stuff. But there is some news. As the dangerous thing TF, we decided to cut down a bit. We weren't getting enough intel, so we made a 25-man TF, and this is our first operation. Everybody that attacked your heroes, I didn't even get to attack, so I'm just gonna show every single thing here. First off, Mustata soloed Tarsier, or Tarsier, however you wanna pronounce it. Of course, it's a pretty low-level operation, but still, solo's always awesome. And a 3-shock Zooka takedown. Let's see how much ice is it. Pretty decent. The damage is not that much, but it's a decent little solo. Next up, Akio. With all Zookas and the takedown of a rocket launcher and some flamethrowers. So the next guy can finish easily. And the next guy is, of course, the one and only Mr. Argus. Who's walking his Zooks to a path to the 7 o'clock of the core. And at this moment, only the rockets and the shock launcher is in range. I don't know why I thought he needed to shock the flamethrower, but it happens. A takedown is a takedown. Meanwhile, with his mini account, he tried to open up Quantum, but he got distracted or something happened during the attack and yeah, mistakes were made. But nothing we cannot fix, of course. The easy way out, just shock everything and use GB on the rest. Does use smokes. Let's see. Good takedown on the rocket, Mr. Swifty. And let's see, where's the next Mr. Alex? Clearing the rest of the rockets and setting up for takedown at 5. It's funny that you see, only Zooka attacks when you're actually dealing with people that care about the operation. Ooh, didn't have enough GB to take everything down. So sad. Mr. Juicebox with the hookah. Ooh, that's not a takedown. Something must have happened. Because hookah at 5 o'clock should have been taken. Oh, he's going for the one-shot defenses. Interesting idea. Okay, I'm a bit speechless by what happened. Final takedown with, ooh, skanks. I think this might be the only attack where Zookas aren't involved because the Tuka of the previous attack was also kind of meh. Ah, going after shock launchers and then the tanks have free game at the core. Nice. Good thinking. Next base, Arkeo with Dredge. Should have used the barrage there. That would have saved a lot of GB. Wow, such a long walk. But nicely grouped up, and the shocks are in time, but not everything is it. That's a shame. Good attack, Arkeo. Keep practicing, you're getting there. You should have shocked a little bit of your own troops, because then you would have had all three shock launchers and not the one firing at you. But of course, after that attack, it's an easy takedown by Mr. Biggus. And only the rocket launchers and machine guns are in range, that's nice. Doom cannon being a little annoying. But a perfectly good takedown by Mr. Biggus. Let's see, what's the next base? Ah yeah. Next and last base is Quantum and... No, we had Quantum. Quick charge is what I meant. Opened up by the one and only Rocky. And with Warriors he's probably going after the shock launcher, I think. Yeah, shock launcher and most likely the shields and doom cannons. Ah. No, rocket launchers it is. Saves a lot of smoke at the landing, taking that shock launcher down. Night Soul with the follow-up and the hookah. And I haven't watched any of these attacks yet, so I have no clue what's gonna happen and what the target is. Ah, rocket launchers it is. Oh, the miss flares. Ooh. Such a shame. We could have had all the rockets there. And let's see what the witch is gonna do. Ah. Finishing where the previous attack ended. Little early on the shocks, but... Let's see if it's still enough to take down all rocket launchers. It is enough to take down all rocket launchers. And accidentally taking out one of the doom cannons as well. Nice. Follow up bubbles. And let's see. Going for the final doom cannon. Going for the shields and... For the rockets. Oh. Could and should have smoked there a little bit because everything is in range there. But doesn't matter. Couple of heroes hookahs just outside the box. And they're getting on GB to help out the final attack by Andy. As you can see, all the mines here are gone and a lot of damage to the buildings, so it's an easy hookah finish at the 1 o'clock of the core. Don't see why he needed to gather up some GB because there's nothing to shock, but it was a takedown, so I cannot complain. Well, you see what's going on there. This was just Foxtrot. The plan is to get a little higher every day and see what we can do. And if this means we can do choke point, curtain call, dead end, and that kind of stuff, that's amazing. And if not, then at least we have enough intels every day to do it, so that's always more fun than when you're just struggling to get one up started. And it's a group with all active people, so big shout out to all of you that joined, and see you all in the next video.